State lawmakers are learning more about Oskaloosa. That's because a group of local leaders visited the state capital in Des Moines this week to talk about the community, its strengths, and local projects. One of those projects is improving Highway 63. The East Central Iowa Transportation Coalition heard a week ago that improvements to Highway 63 are being considered for the Iowa Department of Transportation's five-year plan. But in order for the projects to go through, they have to be funded. And with tight budgets, those sources of funding can get competitive. That's one reason why community leaders visited the Statehouse on Wednesday. Under the serenade of the Oskaloosa High School String Ensemble, the Mahaska County Development Group, along with other community leaders, handed out lunches and spoke with lawmakers about needs in Oskaloosa.
In our area, we have a need to improve US 63 to serve the businesses we have there.
That area is made up of communities around Mahaska County, which Beth Danowski says includes businesses that make up 4 out of the 10 largest industries in Iowa, such as John Deere, Pella Corporation, Cargill, and Vermeer. Danowski says the entire study area makes up $3.6 billion in sales and $607 million in payroll.
We consider ourselves to be kind of a big economic engine, and we need to tell that story.
An economic engine that relies on roads. Roads that, for one business, is causing an increase in the cost of doing business.
Cargill has to pay a premium to get haulers to use US 63 to supply grain to their facility. They need somewhere between 375 and 400 trucks of corn a day to feed their plant.
The process of improving the highway has hit some strides lately. Last August, the Department of Transportation added Highway 63 from Oskaloosa to Waterloo to the commercial industrial network. That designation will make it easier to get state and federal funding. Then, a week ago, the coalition heard from the Iowa Department of Transportation's director, who said it's important to add a bypass on the northwest side of Oskaloosa. Doing that will decrease truck traffic and increase safety in town.
So they're willing to put that somewhere in the five-year plan, and what they've said is 4 to 7 years.
In the meantime, Danowski wants to make sure lawmakers remember the project for whatever funding opportunities come up.
As they consider more appropriations or policies that affect transportation investment, they need to be mindful of what's happening in our area.
And if the meals don't do it, hopefully the music will, as the day first started off with the high school string ensemble playing for the House and Senate to start off the day's session.
This is the first time a music group's opened up one of the sessions, so it's really unique to be a part of that.
And judging from the applause, the group left with a good impression. Danowski also said that in July, the coalition will finish looking at route options for Highway 63 improvements. She expects the coalition to then make a route recommendation that will then be presented to the Department of Transportation.